I was driving around Los Angeles the other day, and I saw this gentleman in a Porsche with a Donald Trump 2016 sticker. He cut me off. I gave him a finger. And then I saw it was a black man driving his Porsche with a Donald Trump 2016 sticker. I hope he stole that car. I hope he stole it. I pray that he stole the car. I did call and report the car stolen. I did. Because I'm a good Samaritan. If he didn't steal it, okay. If he didn't steal it, if he didn't steal it, I'm a good Samaritan. If he, just fuck that guy, man. He had a Donald Trump. Fuck Donald Trump too. They say that if you drive a fancy car or a big truck, you're making up for a lack of penis. I don't think that correlations like that. I think correlations like that are kind of erroneous. I do. But I also think that if you use the word erroneous, you have a really big dick. It's true. Yes. Do you guys have children? You guys, I'm gonna end it here. You guys have children? I hate children. I do. Used to make my job kind of tough too, because I used to teach a kindergarten class. I did. That was my real life, 5 days a week. And everyone's like, why did you teach for so long? I'm like, because health insurance is important to me. And they don't drug test teachers. They don't. Because if they did, there would be no fucking teachers. Exactly. None at all. I wrote a song about that too, like, you gotta smoke the trees to teach the ABCs. Bop, 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 bop. Smoke the trees to teach the ABCs. You guys gonna be singing that tonight. I don't know if you guys ever hung around a 5-year-old, but they never shut the fuck up. They never, just fucking, they talk more than crackheads. They're like, oh. I walked into class one day, and these kids, they say whatever they want. I walked into class one day, they're always singing, Mr. Mateen has a chocolate face, a chocolate face, a chocolate face. It's like, I have a chocolate face. No, well, fuck you assholes, okay? I have a chocolate face. I'm a firm believer, I am a firm believer that you were born homosexual, and I hope you all agree, but like, I had this kid in my class that was gay as a window. And I know that doesn't make any sense to you right now, but just think, he was very open, and you could see right through all of it. Like, you could, he walked into class on the first day of school, he was like, oh my God, Mr. Mateen, this classroom is fabulous. Like, fabulousness, you're born that way. You can't teach fabulousness. You can't, you don't just become fabulous, you are born fabulous. He was very smart and sassy. He was super sassy. He was eating Play-Doh with a knife and fork one day, and I was like, it's like, why are you eating Play-Doh? You know you're not supposed to be eating Play-Doh. And he said, if I'm not supposed to be eating it, why do they make it so delicious? And I was like, it is kind of delicious. So continue, Mr. Fabulous, continue. We used to play this game every day called What's Your Favorite, and every day it would be something new. It was like, so what's your favorite movie? What's your favorite color? On this particular day, it was what's your favorite fruit? It's like, what's your favorite fruit? What's your favorite fruit? So it got to Mr. Fabulous. He's like, oh, Mr. Mateen, Mr. Mateen, Mr. Mateen. My favorite fruit is a banana. B-A-N-A-N-A. And I was like, oh, okay. Okay, banana, that's good. Like, I had to ask him why a banana was his favorite fruit. And I was like, why is banana your favorite fruit? And he says, duh, the potassium. It's like, thank God, thank God. So if he would have said, because it's shaped like a penis, I don't know what I would have did. So my favorite, come on. He was one of my favorite kids. He was great. My least favorite kid was this girl. I call her Odrama Bin Laden. because she terrorized my classroom. She was mean and bossy, and she thought she was always right. And she dropped her coat one day, and she's like, I was like, why don't you come and pick your coat up? She says, how about I give you $20 to stop talking to me? And I was like, bitch, you don't have $20. You're 5 years old. And I was supposed to be nice to her because she had Down syndrome. But it was so hard, guys. Cause she was such a bitch. And I never worked with a kid with Down syndrome before, so I had to look it up and see if like her being mean and bossy and thinking she always right has to do with her condition. And it did. It had everything to do with her condition of being a female and nothing to do with the Down syndrome. Nothing. Nothing. Who fucking tonight? No guy that laughed at that joke. So my biggest pet peeve is when the kids would tattletale on each other. I didn't like that. I hated it. And I said, no one likes a tattletale, because no one likes a tattletale. And I'd be like, here, no one likes a tattletale. You don't tell on your friends. But this is one little boy, he was super persistent. He was all like, Mr. Mateen, he touched my face. Mr. Mateen, he keeps poking me. Mr. Mateen, she took my coloring book. And I was like, hey, man, don't you know that stitches get stitches? And I was like, oh, shit. I just told a 5-year-old that snitches get stitches. I'm gonna get a phone call. I didn't get a phone call. But this kid mom came in the next day and she was pissed. And I was like, oh man. She's like, Mr. Mateen. I'm like, yes. She says, Johnny been saying some very colorful language at home and I think he got it here at school. And I was like, what has he been saying? She said, he told his sister yesterday that snitches get stitches. And I was like, really? I've never heard that phrase a day in my life. I said, he told you where he got it from? She said, no, he didn't say. I just looked Johnny in the face and I started thinking like, you the man, Johnny. You the motherfucking man. And then I had the baby tear just roll down my face. And I wanted to start singing. I believe the children are future. Teach them well and let them lead the way. You guys know the rest. My name is Mateen Stewart. You guys have been fucking amazing. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. Thank you. Come on.